indicative of early nerves, perhaps? Pressure of expectancy, maybe, who knows? Desperate to take the title back to China. Ding Ning was the holder of last year. And indeed, Johnny, the event's been won by a Chinese woman 17 out of the 20 times it's been contested.
That's right, with only Chinese Taipei, Singapore and Japan breaking up that domination. So that's a tactic I think that Tan Ying's going to have to deploy just to keep Zhu Yuling on her toes, is a little bit of defense, and then when the opportunity arises for the right ball to attack, just to mix it up. Otherwise, Zhu Yuling, I think, may just dominate and hold the table there.
Yeah, she does like to play close to the table, doesn't she, and really impose her style on her opponents. And Ying's going to have to give it a good old slap when she comes up close. Back her off. Not that, like that, though.
Absolutely. That was exactly what you were describing, Paul, but maybe Zhu Yuling just disguises that she's actually going to push this one, and maybe Han Ying not too sure where she was going with it, hence the little bit of hesitancy.
Heavy chop from Han Ying there, ball staying loaded and laid and really low as a consequence, rendering it unattackable for the third seed.
Good defending. Zhu Yuling putting that off the side. The way it jumped off her racket would suggest that Han Ying's put in a mega float ball here. So by that, I mean no spin in it. And she's disguised it in her technique. All the best defenders can disguise in the same action, whether they're imparting lots and lots of spin on the ball or under the same action that they actually hit the ball a little bit more thickly and give it no spin whatsoever.
Just misreading the spin there. Normally so secure against defenders, Zhu, and relatively untroubled. Still a little slow to settle out here. People back her for her dependability in this kind of situation. Han Ying is like a defensive wall. Getting that attack ball, but just sort of spilling long of the table. Soft error here. Could pay for it. That's a wounding situation for Han Ying, the German number one and the European hope here. Letting opportunities slip through the net on that forehand.
Still a little bit of a bumpy opening game here, Paul. Neither player really finding their rhythm. Both of them just kind of sussing each other out. No real clear tactics for the moment either. Again, perhaps also an indication of settling into this women's singles final here at the Seamaster Qatar 2016 ITTF World Tour Grand Finals. Big prize at stake. Maybe a little bit of nerves creeping in too. Who knows, even for these most experienced players on the tour.
Yeah, much more positive there from Han Ying. She really got hold of this one with authority, committing fully to it, where before she'd looked tentative on the attack. So reducing the deficit here, just 1 point astray.
A great rally and great tactician style play there from Han Ying. Such great levels of fitness. Look how she's actually taken that ball reasonably early on the backhand defense there, clipping it back on each occasion, trying to change the spins. That was important that she gave that last one a little bit of a dig. Zhu Yuling again thinking it was no spin. Ball's gone down onto the top of the net and out. Brings it back to 8-all.
Yeah, Zhu will be upset with that point because she had her on her string. She brought her in and then spilt long unnecessarily. But when you watch Han Ying, you look at a player who's a defensive chopper and you don't think she's bringing much, but each of these slices are so loaded and varying amounts of spin as well that it's so easy to be errant.
Just as you say that there, Paul, the last backhand chop, I think, from Han Ying looked loaded, but the one that Zhu Yuling lost there against was the one that was the float from the forehand
right.
side. So it's difficult from TV to understand and see, but Han Ying is generating lots of variation in the spins out there. Fantastic tactics.
She's done so well to capitalize on that lucky break with Ding Ning withdrawing and just hopefully trying to ride the wave.
9-all, test of nerve in this opening game.
She was so solid with the short game there as well.
And patient.
Yeah. Building the point so well, engineering beautifully.
Unlucky from Han Ying. You can see she was probably trying to give that one a little bit more. Zhu Yuling was giving her the runaround a little bit, side to side, short and long. Oh, Zhu Yuling looks a little bit more solid.
The European to get us underway. Fast long serve with good effect, nice mix. Incidentally, Johnny, this year in terms of 2016 wins, Han Ying 68%, Zhu Yuling 76% on the World Tour. So year round, 8% more effect for the Chinese player. Brilliant. Waited patiently, soaking up the pace and the blows oncoming, and then just accelerating over the table beautifully.
Excellent play. Look how she turned defense right into attack at the turn of one shot. Here we go. There's the defense. Fantastic. Actually, not very much spin on it. Did look like a chiseled ball. So Zhu Yuling, like many of us may well have done, misreading it, popping it, but Han Ying still has to come in and make the difference on it. Fantastic footwork, anticipation. And execution.
And that ball was there regularly at the early part of the opening game, and she wasn't converting those sitters. Like that, really. Just an easy loop from Zhu off the table. This kind of ball here that she's struggling with, that heavy counter loop from Zhu Yuling, and you're unable to get on top of it for a second time.
That is amazing stuff. It's amazing just how she gets the ball back. Watch how she just reacts and holds the bat up here, Han Ying. Incredible. That's the one there. That is a great shot.
Yeah, momentum swaying throughout, attacking 1 minute, defending the next, then attacking again. Brilliant.
It's like a retrieve more than a defending shot, but the way she plays it and the angle she holds her bat, she actually generates a lot of spin, but not enough on that one.
Another mesmerizing point from both. It's just so good, this women's singles final already, isn't it? Watching the tactics of both and trying to unravel the other's game. Very closely contested. Made her pay then. The ball set up far too high from the third seed, who intends to slap herself on the forehead. Would have converted, Johnny, a lot of these high ball situations. She'd be right on top of this match, but she's been spilling long, and it's almost like Zhu is lulling her to go for it the way she would normally as the defender.
Well,
roles
I think
reversed.
Yeah,
almost.
No, indeed, Paul. And I think for me, what happens is when you're the underdog and you've got a chance to hit a ball, you tend to take a little bit more risk sometimes than you need to, or you force it to be a winner sooner than it should be. I mean, we haven't seen Han Ying miss balls like that all week. But again, when you're playing the top player or someone maybe you're not expected to beat and you haven't beaten before, then you start to make a few errors. I think Han Ying surprised herself that she got that second counter topspin back at the beginning of that rally. That one she didn't miss. Great acceleration cross court.
Yeah, guess what it deserves right here. Sat begging, got the treatment. That's what we're anticipating more than the European hope.
But to play that shot is also reasonably difficult. Again, it's not easy to decipher on TV, but that ball will have been spinning round. Unbelievable amounts of spin from the topspin. So for Han Ying, the counter topspin, she's got to get the angle of her racket correct. If she leaves it too open, she's going to push it away on off the end. She closes it too much, it'll go in the net. So it's really important. And the timing of that ball, you have to clip it at the right time to get the result that Han Ying did.
You've got to dictate to that kind of ball, haven't you, with authority, though? Otherwise, because it is so laden, it'll just overwhelm you. So any hesitancy in it kind of just spills out off the table. So Han Ying playing catch up here to this player, the third seed. With that competitive look in her eyes, fully focused. Well, now Ha Qin with the first game. Very close second here. 7 points each. In it at all. Zhu is almost making a statement for me there, Johnny. Sort of, if you are just joining us. But there's a patience, a sort of assured calmness about Zhu when she's building the point. And it's almost as if, and we haven't seen this all tournament, Han Ying looking like she's got a little bit of panic etched all over her face. Done all the hard work. Look at that. Says it all.
Body language is not positive there, is it, Paul? I mean, I can and know what she's feeling. She had a massive chance there. I mean, she could hit 1,000 of those and she'd make 999 of them.
In the practice hall. In different conditions. This is the match arena playing for the title. That's the thing.
That's loose as well. From Zhu Yuling. I don't think either of these players are particularly comfortable at the moment. I don't know if it's because it's the final and maybe there's a little bit of nerves, as we were talking about earlier on, or slightly overwhelmed, or maybe just not familiar with one another. I mean, it is a bit of a surprise, as you were saying in the intro, Paul, that Han Ying has come this far. So maybe both players just not used to playing one another and still sussing each other out a little bit. Both She's not missing that one.
Yeah, far from settled. And, well, Zhu not having her way there. Han Ying much more assured. But she's been sort of drifting in and out with this high forehand. Some she's made, some she's missed. I'm not convinced. Very close still, though. Zhu with a second game point on her own delivery. Oh, she's found the edge, Han Ying. A timely edge ball. Zhu won't be thinking that, but half of Europe will be. She almost winced and dropped her haunches just to watch that one find the edge.
And what a time to do it. I always believe luck balances out in the end, but what a time for Han Ying at game point down. She's come back now from 10-7.
Frustrated, she couldn't do more there. That one just sat a little too high.
That was well struck. It's a great tactic from Zhu Yuling, playing down the middle of the table, drop shot to either side. On that case, it was the forehand, and then going for the big hit.
So another game point opportunity then for the Chinese player. Doesn't need another invitation. Zhu Yuling third. Made it very watchable, though, because they're both a little tight. That said, we've seen some terrific ball on several points.
Yeah, I think the occasion, it's a big one, right, Paul? It's the grand finale of the whole season resting here. To be crowned champion is just a phenomenal achievement, and you go down in history on that elusive list, exclusive list.
It's a massive accolade, isn't it?
Absolutely. So maybe it has having a bit of an impact on both players.
Han Ying being the first European ever to make the final. You know, can she go on better and etch her name on that illustrious roll of honour board as they change the ball here? Just warming it up. Zhu Yuling with the pressure of expectancy. China winning the title last year in Ding Ning, who pulled out with fever. Chinese will be desperate for her to bring the title home. Expectation of a nation.
Another crack ball as well there, Paul. Players warming that other one up. New one. Seen a lot this week. Rally like a game of chess. So both players playing the push ball at the beginning of that rally. Getting into position. Zhu Yuling found it. Just couldn't convert the follow-up. I think if Zhu Yuling can just remove these odd errors and just be strong, hold the table, on the points that she's won, she's used the variation in power, spin, touch, so that she's brought Han Ying in and out, side to side, mixing up the spins, making it difficult for Han Ying. For the German on the far side, Han Ying, it's about variation as well then. Attack when she can. She has been getting the chances. She just needs to be patient and play it relaxed, just like that one.
She has looked so assured against the might of Japan. She's played both 16-year-old youngsters, the young Miurano and Mimaeto, and really looked good in defense, rock solid. But Zhu seemingly has several ways to pick that defensive lock. She's exposing Han Ying more often than not. But the variety in this match, as you said, it really is quite standout, the way that they're asking multiple different questions, both of them.
once again, Han Ying's created the attacking position. You can see the frustration. Watch how she gets this fastball back. Here it comes, this one. Gets it back in the backhand side. She's created the chance there. Zhu Yuling's hesitated on the push, but Han Ying hasn't converted, and those points could be crucial.
Oh, brilliant point. As you say, Johnny, you know, that high forehand that we've seen her miss time and again, there must be five or six of them now, and that over the course of a match really starts to accrue against you. That's a lot of points that you're giving to Zhu Yuling that should rightfully be yours. Fast long serve, setting the point up beautifully from Zhu. Ying straining every sinew to get back into this one. It's a thankless task when you're playing a Chinese player and they're starting to get on a little bit of a roll and the scoreboard is strangling you at the same time.
A bit erratic.
Starting to reel away from the European slowly here.
And I just wonder if those missed balls, just like that one, a couple more in this game, I mean, those points go the other way. Could be an entirely different situation. Well played there, though, taking on Zhu Yuling on a counter forehand topspin rally. Watch the ball arc over the net, nice and high. Use the spin to let the ball come back down onto the table. Much more safe than trying to hit it flat.
Gesturing frustration there. Because it's quite significant normally how Zhu can establish herself really early in the point, not necessarily with pace, but with precision of spin, variant placement, varying the attack lines nicely.
Ah, it's great defending. Really deep. We'll see this in the rerun. We'll see how deep the ball lands, right close to the baseline.
Han Ying's done well to recover this game. Locked in at 7 points all. Can she swing it her way?
Ooh, mistakes now creeping in. Zhu Yuling's just lost her concentration there, the 21-year-old world number four. Well played, Han Ying. 4 points on the bounce. Worked her way back into this here. First two games very close, only 2 points in it. Both went for Zhu Yuling though.
Han Ying has only ever once taken a game off of Zhu, and so she'd delight herself to take one here and square this match. A lot of work to do though. Ball just came off and struck her in the jaw, or maybe it was even the racket itself. Perhaps that's a wake-up call. I love the way that Zhu goes into that soft-handed, delicate stuff, into the real explosive power in the blink of an eye. Well done, Han Ying. Where she'd been fallible before, turning defence into attack, got the short ball, put a little extra spin and percentage and leeway on this just to ensure it. Good job. So, the German number one stays in touch at the back end of this second game one you feel that's a must winner for her, really. Third game, beg your pardon.
Me in terms of Han Ying, what she's done so well to contain Zhu Yuling, prevent her from exploding around the table, but then when the chance arises and presents itself, she misses it.
It's almost like Zhu is saying, call yourself a defender, come on then, let's go at it, come on, bring it on. And then when Han Ying, as you say, she gets the opportunity and blows it. Germans with hands on heads in bars all around the world, I'm sure. Frustrated.
Another mistake from Zhu Yuling, though. Very edgy.
It's far from being one-sided. So, deadlock, deuce. 10 points all. It'll be decided by two. For Han Ying, you've got to agree, Johnny, this is a must-win game.
Absolutely.
Brilliant change up from Zhu Yuling. Third seed right on top of that point throughout. Vicious forehand acceleration. So, game point opportunity to the Chinese player for a 3-point lead, but it is on the serve of Han Ying. It is Zhu Yuling that takes the third. Here's Han Ying, German number one, start of game four.
For me, Paul, what'll be interesting now is the mindset of each of these players. Well, maybe Zhu Yuling's just answered it. I think that last game was crucial for both players. You know, had Han Ying managed to just take it, I think she'd have been in the ascendancy, and I think Zhu Yuling would have asked a lot of questions of herself and maybe some doubt creeping in. As it turns out, it was Zhu Yuling who took it, and now at 3-0, I wonder what that does to each of the two players' mindsets. Does Zhu Yuling now just relax because she's 3-0 up? The first point she unleashed that big ball.
Yeah,
she's just
playing.
Unleashed another one. Is she playing with freedom?
Yeah, much more expansive now, Johnny. You can see she's just taken a big sigh of relief, I think, psychologically, and she's now just unleashing the fury. She can be much more inventive. She's got that three-game cushion.
And then, by contrast, maybe Han Ying completely relaxes because she thinks, you know what?
The shower is almost running.
This has been tight. I'm 3-0 down. Three tight games. I've missed a few smashes and hits. Do you know what? I'm going to relax and I'm just going to give it a go. And who knows? When you're in that type of position, sometimes it all clicks back into action. See, I think Zhu Yuling's swinging with more intent now. But that is, yeah, but super defending from Han Ying. Just incredible retrieving. That one is just tremendous. Looked as if she anticipated the Zhu Yuling drop shot. She was coming in with the big sidewinder, the big forehand. Ah, you see, that's good. Break of the wrist. Difficult to do. I'd suggest that's the sign of a confident player right now, having zipped that one down the line into the Han Ying backhand from Zhu Yuling.
Well, we were always anticipating a high quality affair when this lineup occurred. What with the defensive chopper and the resilient defense of Han Ying. She's been a little exposed today by Zhu Yuling, who's had that added acceleration and an edge in consistency when she's needed to. Oh, thunderous right at the body of Pan Ying. So she's created a three-point lead here and a three-game buffer as the third seed, looking in a commanding position now.
That's fantastic attack against the defense from Zhu Yuling. She is now swinging with that level of freedom at 3-0, 5-2. But hang on a second.
We spoke of this before, didn't we? Nothing to lose. Wounded bear syndrome. Let's have a go.
So I think we're seeing both kind of changes at 3-0 that you may expect in a sporting scenario. Zhu Yuling swinging with real intent and a sense of relaxation. Han Ying, though, just having a go. They've broken another ball. Third ball of the match.
Well, Han Ying starting to look a little dismantled now. Zhu Yuling looking very comfortable against the chopper. And of course, all that exposure that she's had over the years against the might of the Chinese opponents, her compatriots, and playing in the China Super League, 24 wins, only two losses this year. She is just so comfortable with this kind of tempo match, you can see. Much more settled than she did at the beginning of the match, that's for sure. Oh, get your protractor out. Look at those angles.
Calm as you like. Awesome there from Zhu Yuling and Han Ying. Both players, wonderful table tennis. Look at the angle Han Ying plays. Then Zhu Yuling comes around it.
A smile at Storebra.
Yeah, goes for the one round the net. But Zhu equal to it, and it's looking inevitable now, Paul.
Yeah, she's set sail for home now, just 2 points away from the title, Zhu Yuling.
It'll be interesting if this does convert to hear what she has to say in the post-press conference. I guarantee she'll say it was far from easy, because whilst a 4-0, if it is to be a 4-0, is clearly seemingly easy victory, when you look at the scores and what has happened out here, it's far from it, really.
The women's singles title.